Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. Outside the International Space Station, Expedition 48 Commander Jeff Williams and Flight Engineer Kate Rubins of NASA conducted a spacewalk September 1st to retract a thermal radiator, install the first of several enhanced high-definition cameras on the station's truss, and tighten bolts on a joint that enables one of the station's solar arrays to rotate. This was the second spacewalk for the pair in just 13 days. They installed the station's first international docking adapter during their previous spacewalk on August 19th. The adapter will provide a parking place for new U.S. commercial crew spacecraft, delivering astronauts to the station on future missions. On August 30th, cameras outside the International Space Station captured images of three powerful tropical systems churning across the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans. Hurricane Lester was seen as it moved westward across the Pacific, packing 125 miles per hour winds. Hurricane Madeline also was seen making a westerly trek in the Pacific with winds in excess of 130 miles per hour. At the time, both storms were on a track that could threaten Hawaii. Station cameras also captured views of Hurricane Gaston as it churned across the open Atlantic. When this video was recorded, that storm had winds of 100 miles per hour. The next crews in line to serve aboard the International Space Station are busy preparing for their respective missions. The Expedition 4950 crew, including NASA's Shane Kimbrough, is conducting crew qualification training in Star City, Russia. Kimbrough and cosmonauts Andrei Borisenko and Sergei Rysakov of the Russian space agency Roscosmos will launch on September 23rd from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. Following them will be Expedition 5051. That crew, which includes NASA astronaut Peggy Whitson, previewed their mission during an August 30th news conference at Johnson Space Center in Houston. Launch for Expedition 5051 is targeted for November. Using data from NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory and other telescopes, researchers have discovered the most distant galaxy cluster on record. This composite image shows the galaxy cluster, known as CLJ1001+0220. It's located about 11.1 billion light years from Earth and may have been imaged shortly after it was born, a brief but important stage of cluster evolution never seen before. This cluster is remarkable because of its high levels of star formation in galaxies near its center. Stars are forming there at a rate equivalent to more than 3,000 a year. NASA's Juno spacecraft successfully completed the first and closest of its 36 orbital flybys of Jupiter on August 27th, zipping past the planet about 2,600 miles above its swirling clouds. This also was the first time Juno's entire suite of science instruments was activated and looking at the giant planet as the spacecraft zoomed past, resulting in the highest resolution views yet of the Jovian atmosphere and the first glimpses of Jupiter's north and south poles. Juno's mission to gather data on Jupiter's polar regions is targeted to last until February 2018. On August 31st, NASA headquarters hosted a program titled New Horizons Mission to Pluto and Beyond. The event featured a presentation from Alan Stern, principal investigator of NASA's New Horizons mission, about the spacecraft's historic encounter with the Pluto system in 2015 and what's planned for the extended mission. New Horizons currently is traveling in the Kuiper Belt beyond Pluto. The spacecraft is on its way to a New Year's Day encounter in 2019 with an ancient object considered to be an early building block of the solar system. New Horizons continues to send back interesting imagery of the region. This animated series of images, released on August 31st, shows a dwarf planet called Quasar, which at 690 miles in diameter is roughly half the size of Pluto. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.